I've become a really good cleaner over the years. I wish I could say I was a better cleaner.
You just went and bought a harness?
Yeah. I gave my stuff away about 6 months ago.
You knew the minute you gave it away you were going to climb again.
I know.
You probably would have bought new stuff anyway.
I know, exactly. That's what I tell myself.
Did you get new shoes too?
No, I had shoes, but I didn't buy new shoes.
I fell on that.
Oh man, my
eye. 225 pounds falling on that little rinky-dink thing. Can't tell you how many times I've taken off without a chalk bag. Get 3/4 of the way up there, it's like...
I'm gonna be climbing around a chalk bag today.
You don't have one?
No. That's what I forgot.
It's like triple check of just stuff, so like, okay, that's good. That's good. Everything's good. Got a belay device, that's good. Once it gets a little hard, then it's just, for me, it's just like, if I sit and think about how hard it is, or if I'm scared, if I sit and think about how scared I am, that's when it's like, okay, this is gonna get worse and worse and worse. So usually I'll just take a chance. I'll just go for it. It's worked out well so far.
Calculated risk.
Have fun.
All right. You know, honestly, the reason I started doing it is because it looked fun, it looked adventurous, and then also for fitness. Like, I wasn't doing CrossFit when I started doing it. This was my idea of fitness. It's kind of changed, but you know, now the adventure part of it is a bigger deal than it used to be.
Nothing else in the entire world matters when you're climbing. Because all you can think about is, I gotta get past this, I gotta get through this move, and literally, you can't think about anything else. It's like CrossFit in the sense that no matter what, you're never going to be satisfied. You're never going to find the end. Like, you're never going to arrive.
I fell in love with it. Just a way to get out, a way to be in the outdoors, and challenge yourself to get to push your limit. You know, in the weight room, we push our limit one way. In a CrossFit gym, this is another way to push your body physically and mentally. Because some of the things you have to do is... some of the situations you put yourself in are pretty extreme.
I love the relationships you build when you climb because they're something different about being on the end of a rope with somebody that is like holding your life. I think that's fun. You build a bond, you know, like Matt and I were climbing partners long before we were dating.
The Chans, they're solid. They knew what they're doing. You know, when we're setting up, I'm looking at what they're doing and the procedure and how they're methodically walking through everything. Totally safe.
it's not
off rappel
mode.
That is great.
You now know what an inside of an iPhone looks like.
The interesting part about this area is that it's a kind of like a wintertime destination.
Yeah.
So like originally all the Yosemite climbing bums would go climb all spring and summer and fall in Yosemite, and then they'd come here and crag, and they thought of it as training. So it's pretty neat. It's a pretty neat little area, and it's February, and it's easily take your shirt off, you know?
Yeah.
Controlling your fear, you know? Your natural tendency is to back off, and it's cool because you get to keep pushing forward, and you can see, just like weightlifting, you see your numbers get better as far as grades that you're climbing. But for me, it's just like the confidence in, you know, stuff that you do in CrossFit. You know, whether it's consistently snatching 225 any day of the week, you just walk up to it. Same as climbing a 5.7. Go up there, climb 5.7 any day of the week, and you can have an adventure every single time you do it, you know? The part that's serene about it is that it's like, you're out in the middle of nowhere, there's no one there to help you. It's kind of, there's solace in that, and it's all about the adventure with the person or persons that you're with. You really get to see like what people are made of when they're scared, you know? Tree will tell you that. When you're out here by yourself and, or you know, with just a couple people, it's peaceful. It's cool.
Games again this year?
Yeah. Yep. for a while I was kind of hesitant in talking about it at all, whether, you know, when somebody would ask me, I wouldn't really answer it. It's like, I don't know, we'll see how I'm feeling. But it's time to commit. Yes, I am. I'm indifferent about how I finish. I'm excited about the process. It's nerve-wracking putting yourself out there when you're not 100% and people are getting so much better and stuff like that. But that's part of the game, man. It's part of the game. I'm 37 years old. I want to hit it one more time hard.